Yeah, it's 103.2 Dublin City FM. It's Sinead O'Folk and Ballot Show. And I have a very, very, two very special guests here at the moment. I'll tell you now in a few moments who we have. I'm sure those of you on the old Facebook know who's in here tonight. We have a very special guest, Joe Dunn, and we have Gavin Walsh in here with him as well. Two guys going to talk about music, play music, and looking forward to that. So as I always say, put on the old cup of tea, and if you want to dance in the kitchen, we won't stop you. You're welcome, lads. Welcome, Joe. I haven't seen you in a while. And
thanks very much, Ciarán. Yeah,
you're very welcome. Actually. And Gavin, come over to that mic and say hello to us all here. Just for,
how's it going? You well?
We believe Gavin is a kind of a shy kind of fella, but we'll pull something out of him as we go through the programme. So certainly pull music out of him. Joe, first thing I want to say is I haven't touched base with you in a while, and you've been in touch with this programme since it started, and you also have a track off an album that came off the station here way back, some years back. It must be 15 years ago. We all had a couple of tracks on the
yeah, that was a great compilation. Yeah.
So I want to welcome you back here to the program.
Thanks a million.
And to the station here, it's great to see you again, Joe. I want to go right back. I know you quite a few years now, and I'm not going to mention Watering Hole up in the mountains, but you played in it for, I'd say you're probably one of the longest men playing a gig in one place on a Wednesday night. And some great musicians have gone through that situation that you played. I know there was pipers and fiddle players and all sorts of people. Jerry O'Connor was one way back. He used to play with you up there quite a lot. And it was a great time. Joe, music goes back a long time with you, yeah?
It does, yeah. I had a recorder, like a tin whistle, shoved in my mouth in West Row in the inner city when I was seven.
Seven?
Yeah. And play that.
And you
play that. And then I moved on to the recorder, or to the clarinet when I was about 9, 10.
Yeah.
I was taught by a guy out of the army, number one band, John Redmond, I think was his name. Lovely man.
Yeah.
You know, back in an era, you can imagine what an inner city school was like in 1974. It was fairly rough.
It was a tough place.
tough place. So that's where I began the music. There was a guy, a brother there called Jack Manning. So he started three school bands, you know?
Yeah.
And, you know, a lot of the people who were in that stuff have gone on to teach music. I teach music in schools and stuff like that, you know. So that's where I started, you know, and music in the family as well. So, and then I went away from the music for years and years. Yeah. And
people come back into music in strange ways and leave it in strange ways as well and come back again. But one I want to say, you're one fine musician that I've seen playing, and I've always enjoyed the company of your music. Thanks. And many a time I was up in that Watering Hole, up in the hills there, and you were playing on Wednesday.
Yeah.
And there were some mighty sessions.
It was amazing.
You wouldn't get them anywhere. So, Gavin, come over to the mic for a minute. I told you we'll pull them in here, no bother at all. Gavin, I want to, before we get you to play a bit of music, and you and Joe together, where are you from? Are you for a dub?
I'm from Ballantyre, around the corner from Joe, actually.
Ah, some lovely Ballantyre. We're all from Ballantyre.
Yeah,
because I know Gavin to see, and Gavin, we were talking off air before the programme, and Gavin said, remember you playing in the Blue Light and that. Mm-hmm. And you're also playing music out there as well, but you're working with Joe at the moment, recording, well, you've nearly have the album finished, yeah?
Yeah, we're very close now after a few weeks of recording.
Yeah,
years.
Great. A few weeks.
Long time, anyway.
7 weeks.
7 weeks.
by 52.
Yeah, exactly. 7 years. Yeah.
Yeah, but there's nothing wrong with that because I'm sure it's really. We have some sample tracks of it here. Anyway, we're going to play off.
Yeah. Well, anyway, just to finish, I know it's been 7 years, but actually, the Mona Lisa took 8.
Did it?
Seemingly.
Right.
So I think this is going to be as good as the Mona Lisa.
Don't call it the Mona. What's one? Have you a name on the show? The name of the album?
We've called it Off the Richter.
Right, okay, we'll find out more about that. So Gavin, you're playing, is it guitar you play? Do you play other instruments or?
Yeah, I play a bit of piano and you know, drums sometimes, but mainly guitar. Yeah,
so you're out there on the scene, gigging away out there.
Yeah, I mean, I have a few groups, just tipping away,
Yeah, good man.
Making me mark on the world.
Great, okay. Joe, can I get a track off you? Because a bit of music would be great to get back into the chat.
Delighted. And it's lovely to be nice here and relaxed here with you, Ciarán, and fair play to you. And,
well, as you always say, as you can see in front of me, I have nothing wrote down. And I think it's a great way to do the programme. I think it's great that organically sit here. It's like sitting in a sitting room with a pot of tea in front of you. You have got the pot of tea. If Helen's here, she'd have the tea for you. But anyway.
As the fella says, my plan is that I don't have a plan.
Yeah.
It's a good plan, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely, because he just follows its way. Yeah. What are you going to do for us?
Just going to start off with a song I wrote a few years back now. This is a song called Heaven's Way.
Tell us about it, Joe.
And you see, some of the songs I can remember when they came, and some of them I can't remember anything.
Yeah.
But I suppose it's a song about that maybe, hopefully, you know, there is another dimension after this world, you know, and the opening line of the song is the feel of strength in your father's arms, you know.
Oh, it's a great lyric.
Do you know what I mean? Like, so that maybe...
Why'd you pick that lyric up when you just came?
That just came, yeah. So, yeah. You know, and it's Don't Close the Way to Heaven, you know, the way the world is closing it these days, you know, so...
Yeah.
It's a song. It's a kind of a song. That's the type of thing it's called, yeah. Don't Close Heaven's Way. Give it a go anyway and see what happens, yeah. Goes something like this. We walk the road now, the road of darkness. We've walked that road till the very end. We could not see before the sunset. We could not see before the dawn. The feel of strength now in your father's arm, with no fear or no alarm. I've come here to unlock your dreams, dispel the darkness, draw the light so near. Don't close heaven's way, don't close it at all. Don't close heaven's way, don't close it at all. The angels guide heaven's way, with whispered words they say. The angels guide heaven's way. Walk that road till the very end. We could not see before the sunset. We could not see before the dawn. Oh, peace awaits you now at every turn. You search forever in a swirling storm. Come now to a land, to a hand that guides you. Come now to a place where we call home.
Your dreams. dispel the darkness, draw the light so near. Don't close heaven's way, don't close it at all. The angels guide heaven's way, with whispered words they say. Don't close heaven's way, don't close it at all. Whispered words they say, whispered words they say, whispered words they say. Hey, 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 don't close heaven's way, oh no please, don't close it at all.
That's Joe Goodone and Gavin Walsh here in 103.2 Dublin CFM. Joe, that's absolutely gorgeous.
Oh, thanks a million.
I know you're a very spiritual man for the all the years. I know you do the masses as well up in Ballinteri. Yeah, you're still playing on the Sunday up.
I am, yeah. Some of the best music ever, yeah. Absolutely, yeah. It's a big part of my life, Kieran. Saved me life.
Yeah.
It's part of my life.
It's, yeah, absolutely.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know, it keeps me going. Yeah. It gets me through the day, you know.
So the song has certainly got something to say in a lovely way. And it's a lovely song.
Oh, thanks a million.
Some beautiful lyrics in there.
Yeah. And a lot of the songs, Kieran, to be quite honest with you, they come to me in about 3 or 4 minutes, to be quite honest with you. Like,
yeah.
I feel like I'm only just a channel. That's to be quite honest with you.
No. You have something to say. There's no doubt about it. And well done on that song, Joe. It's absolutely gorgeous.
Thank you.
Gavin is recording the album for you. Is he? He's doing all the recording? Or?
Yeah, we started off a few years ago and we did a first dry run of it. And We just kept at it and, you know, chipping away weekends when we had time, all the rest of it. And sure, fair play to Gavin, you know, we call it a Ludford Breeze production because we're from Ludford, you know.
There's
a lot of music in Ludford up in Ballinteri, the coal trains. Jason Bourne, the comedian, is the next door neighbour.
The whole road
is like Portobello Road in London,
you know. It's
a very musical, artistic road, you know. Gavin's the whole area around there, a lot of music. So Gavin, the two of us have been working away on our own silently. Recording for the last 7 years, have some amazing musicians. Maybe we'll talk about them later.
Yeah, that's
that
right.
Are on this album.
Yeah,
some, I want to talk some of the top musicians in the city.
My name is Kieran Kelly. It's the Shade of Folk and Ballad Show, and our special guest in here, and I know you're enjoying him. A great friend of mine from way back years. We made great friends with one another in around the music, and that's what the power of music has. He's here tonight. His name is Joe Don, and the man who has beside him is a fine musician, and that's Gavin Walsh. Joe, take it away.
Thanks very much. This is a song I wrote called The Fall. That I could not hear the meaning through the storm. You took my hand, you laid the plan from the moment that I came in to this land. And indifference was my sin that caused all the graces that I let fall from my hands. And the truth tonight will never hide how you held me, caressed me with a pen. And I could not live without you. And I could not live at all. I
could not live without you. 'Cause you break my every the love between the maker and the me. And although those hounds snap at your feet, they will never stop you from the face you seek. I could not live without you, and I could not live at all. I could not live without you, 'cause you break my every
Joe Dunn is absolutely sounding brilliant here tonight, and I know the sound is absolutely fantastic because I'm listening to it. Some of the weeks, Joe, you have people in and just the sound doesn't be as good as what you want, but I can certainly tell you tonight's sound is really, really like a live recording coming out without an audience. It's really, really lovely. And Gavin's guitar work, the two of them, everything's complementing one another. There's nothing overshadowing anything. Joe, I want to go back to the album that you've almost finished. And by the sound of things, I haven't heard you sounding better in all the time I know you. Listening to the stuff that you're doing live and listening to what you have on CD here, I do think that you should make sure, you know, Electric Picnics have all sorts of levels of stage for the level of whatever, you know.
Yeah.
And I think you're easily qualified, in my opinion, to sit on any stage anywhere.
Yeah. Thanks, Gary.
Your quality, you know, I play around music and play in pubs and bar, but I'd never look at myself as that quality, and I always say there's a notch more of people like yourself, Joe. So really, you know, get yourself out there this time around. It's never too late, you know, never too late. I know your years, and you've always said that this work that you have here is absolutely fantastic.
The songs are
really, and I'm dying to hear the finished product with all the different musicians on it. What I'm hearing on the CD that you have here is just wonderful. So you need to really, really push yourself.
So hopefully, if there's somebody I can connect with, I just need someone to give me a hand there in the management end of stuff. You know what I mean? I can do a certain amount myself, but I mean, I'm not making excuses. But I'm sort of ready to go. So if someone, you know, if I can click in with somebody now when we bring it to that stage to get out there, do the nice spots, I'm all for it.
Joe, last year, last Christmas, I went down to Galway out to Uachtarad, and I had two programs recorded in one day, and we went out and we set up the studio in the house on the lakes in the afternoon, and we had a great recording, and then we went to the Boat Inn on that night, and we recorded another program there with all different great musicians from all of that way. What's coming to me now is I'd love to do it this Christmas again, and maybe with yourself if you would accept that, I'll set up a venue, and you're very welcome to bring all your musician friends, because I think Christmas time is a good time to do it. Lots of lads are around.
Yeah, people are feeling good here.
We kind of pick a time over Christmas where it might be wonderful to do, and we set up a little place, and we certainly do it out around the Dundrum, Rathfarn and Ballantyre kind of area.
Yeah, yeah.
If you would accept that invitation.
Okay, sure, we'll give it a go. Absolutely.
What we do is we set up the studio, similar to here, we set up a table, and we bring the musicians around, and we'd have a live audience in there as well, and we got two great shows, I have to say.
Yeah, I heard one of them. It was brilliant. Yeah, it was great. Yeah. Donegal O'Doolan lives again. Fair play to you.
Joe, I'm going to play track number three off the recording that you have in.
This is a song called Little Girl.
Tell us about that, Joe.
So Little Girl, Little Girl is about a little girl that myself and my wife had, but it didn't last too long. Do you know sort of way?
Yeah.
It was just in one of the early sort of things, you know, it was about a 3 or 4 month thing.
Yeah.
So this song is dedicated to her. It's a very joyful song, you know what I mean? It's a lovely song. It's a great, gorgeous song. So
great.
So
pleasure here, Joe.
It's called Little Girl, yeah.
We'll let you take a break there and a breather. Thank you. And if you want to get a sup of water, we'll get that organised for you anyway. Okay, you're listening to 103.2 Dublin CFM. My name is Kieran Kelly. It's Sinead, the Folk and Ballad Show. As you know, we're 18 years sitting here in the seat doing this programme. Mick O'Brien and myself have been tied up doing this, and we've had some great, great nights in here. And tonight is certainly one of those special nights for our special guests, Joe Don and Gavin Walsh. Have a listen to this track.
You wonder if the world is spinning, spinning, surely it is. And are the waves a lapping, or is it just a dream? And all of the flowers have turned to pink and green. And mama, she is rocking the cradle of your dreams. Don't wake up, little girl, don't wake up. Don't wake up. The golden book of magic has opened, so it seems, to break a smile upon the face of every child that dreams. So run up to the sandy hill, the rushes there to meet, and jump into the sand below your holiday retreat. Don't wake up, little girl, don't wake up. Don't wake up. Don't wake up, little girl. The deep, you can command the stars above to worship at her feet. Below, 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 what whispers in her sleep? The rocking world, the rocking world, the rocking world asleep. The rocking world, the rocking world. Little girl,
that's the wonderful Joe Dunn, that's who it is, and you're hearing some really, really nice music here tonight. That's off the album, the forthcoming album that's coming out. Gavin, the album you received, I heard earlier on, we've talked about, you just received the masters and the whole thing back from Germany.
Yeah.
What's it sounding like?
I haven't really got my head around it yet, because it's just in the post, but
Yeah,
it's supposed to be pretty good gear to use. I've read some great reviews about it, so there's still a bit of work to do before it goes to mastering, but it's going to be pretty hot, I think.
Yeah,
I'm hoping, you know.
Have you enjoyed the project all the time?
Oh, brilliant! Yeah,
every bit of it you've enjoyed, no bother.
Absolutely, yeah.
Yeah, and is it just guitar you're playing, or is there any other instruments you're playing on it?
I play keyboards and a few bass and stuff like that. On a few of the tracks.
Effects. Yeah. He's the effects specialist. He's the effects department.
Yeah. And some of the orchestration and stuff like that, you know.
Okay. And also, you're actually, you're just stepping away from Joe for a second to get a little bit about yourself. You're playing around town. You're playing in the Porterhouse on a Friday, is it?
No. I play in McLaughlin's Bar.
In Dunleary.
Every couple of Fridays.
Okay.
Oh, sorry, Saturdays with a friend of mine, Mark Fagan.
Right.
We just do a duo set there.
Yeah,
it's good. It's good. No, we've only started there recently, but it's the first gig went well. So
great.
And I'm in another band called Kickback, which we've been doing the rounds.
Yeah.
For a good few years now. So
I've heard the band,
you know, cover band, you know.
And are you gigging over this weekend or anything? Do you want to plug a gig or anything there for yourselves?
Yeah, as far as I know, I didn't check now, but I think we're playing the Klonsky House on
Saturday. I see that. Got music in it.
Yeah, pop on down.
On Saturday night?
Saturday night,
God, I might drop in there and I'll catch Joe then on Thursday night.
Yeah.
Because when you're playing gigging out stuff yourself, and then, you don't tend to get out to somebody else. It's time to do it. I think for me, the darker winter nights is great, because you kind of have to get up and go.
Yeah,
it's easy to stay back in and sit in the garden and just chill out and stuff. But when it gets dark, it's nice to get out and get out of the house, because the old dark noise is very long from 6 o'clock onwards.
Absolutely, you've got to move.
you're finding that you think it's 11 o'clock and it's only 8 o'clock in the evening. So it is. Joe, that track off the album is really lovely as well.
A little girl.
There's some lovely, they finish off with it, it's lovely, kind of mellow music. Yeah, it's lovely.
Lovely,
So I'm sure the album is up and down like that. You have different melodies.
Yeah, there's heavy gun stuff, you know. Some of it's political, and then some of it's songs like That Little Girl, and there's some dreamy songs.
I don't know if someone is saying something from the heart and stuff. You're not a politician, so I don't think it's political. I think it's what you see from your view. I think if politicians were recording albums and saying something like that, what you're saying,
no one would be listening to them.
Maybe it is political that way. But
I suppose anti-establishment or anti...
Well, it's a story, Joe. It's in front of us every day. You know what I mean? It's on the television. You can't pick up social media and it's all in front of you.
So,
I mean, what you're doing is just expressing a view, and a wonderful view, by the way, and a passion of a view. So I don't look at you as a political writer or a political. I think you're just saying something from your heart.
Yeah, thanks. Yeah, okay, right. Yeah,
I don't. Enough, that's just me looking in. You might feel different, or someone else might feel different. I think too many people kind of try to put music or song down by saying, "Oh, that's political." No, I don't necessarily think that your work is political, Joe. I think it's something that comes from inside your heart, and you're saying something that you see. And you're not asking anyone to believe it. You're not asking anyone to agree with it or anything like that. Well, politicians do. So you're not a politician, Joe.
Do you know what? I'm gonna have to record that last few sentences you said, because now I know what to call myself. Probably. Will you tell me later exactly what
you
said?
No.
But fair play to you. You're on the ball, Kieran. Yeah, it's just when somebody else sees it. You know what I mean? I don't know. I'm just opening mouth sometimes.
But we've so many bands in Ireland where people jump on them. I mean, you know, the Hearts. Well, you know, kind of put the Hearts down as a political band.
Yeah.
They had something to say. And these were a bunch of guys who wanted to say something that they saw, like yourself.
Yeah.
You know, that's and people were trying to brand them as political bands. You know, I don't necessarily believe that, and I don't necessarily see it as that.
Yeah,
and well done to you.
And I suppose, you know, and I think back, like my own father died when I was very young, you know, and I remember, fair play to him, he wouldn't give us the foreign channels, as they was known back then. There was only RT1, you know.
It wasn't allowed, Joe.
No, myself, my brother Fintan, and Declan, and we'd say, why won't you, you know, why can't we have the BBC? And he said, listen, it took 800 years to get them out of the country. I'm not bringing them into the country. I hope I'm not upsetting anybody. But you know what I mean? He was a passive nationalist or whatever you want to call it. In other words, the culture, you know, and we used to just sit in the room and there was the telly was off. He was a young man, he was only 52 when he was taken from us, but he used to sit there with us as a family and talk about the stars and the universe.
And
I didn't know him for that long, but I tell you one thing, he certainly set me up, and I owed a great debt to him.
You listen to Joe Dunn here and Gavin Walsh here on 103.2 WCFM. There are special guests on the programme here tonight. What are you going to sing for us, Joe?
This is a song I wrote called Paradise.
Right.
Okay, so, and I had started to write the song, and about a week later, and a good friend of mine, a man called Charlie Bradley, he was from up around Dundrum, Ballinteer area, used to be the bouncer in Lily Bordello's and places like that.
Right.
He was a top end sort of minder and whatever. But this is one of the strongest guys I ever knew in my life, you know?
Yeah.
And I gave him a lift. He went away to be a bodyguard for a guy in Spain, you know?
Yeah.
Like, so he was fairly sought after, you know? Great guy, big guy, muscly guy, top of the range, you know? And, you know, 4 months later, he was gone.
Jeez.
So his sister asked me to sing, I just finished off the song, and I sang this at his funeral. And then this is actually on the album, you know.
Brilliant. Take it away.
It's a song called Paradise.
Paradise.
Little past. For Generation Z comes to Dublin. A new education and well-being experience for 15 to 20-year-olds. It's Seminar at the RDS October 11th to 13th, featuring interactive workshops by the very best youth organisations and incredible speakers. To see who, go to seminar.ie. Move over, millennials. This one's for Generation Z. Seminar, RDS, October 11th to 13th. Limited €5 early bird tickets remain. See seminar.ie.
The traditional music of Ireland, its stories, its energy, its beauty, the very heart of our culture. Join me, Ken Tuohy, every Monday night at 9 p.m. for Trad at Heart.
On the stroke of midday, every Saturday on 103.2 Dublin City FM, Peter Grogan says, it's all in the song. And with you along as company, I have the songs to prove it.
Dublin City FM, where lyrics sound better.
Yes, and Joe Dunn's lyrics are sounding incredible here tonight on 103.2 Dublin City FM. Joe, another great song.
Cheers.
You're really born on that one, that CD now, I'll tell you. The old vinyl's well gone, down under the old CD.
Yeah.
Jeff does a lot of your artwork. Is he going to do the artwork on the next one around?
Yeah, there's a little bit of his artwork. Yeah, there's a thing I had in mind for Donkey's Years that I'd seen a picture that he'd done. It's called Red Presence. So yeah, it's going to be, hopefully, please God, yeah, with his kind permission, it's going to be on the front of the CD, like the Hail Caesar one.
Yeah,
you know? So,
yeah.
So his stuff is going to go on it.
He's a very distinctive artist.
Absolutely, yeah. And he's been all there. He's met them all. He's gas. He's, you know, you've seen him over the years. I remember, what's your man out of the Who? Robert Dalty, is it? Who's the name?
Roger Dalty, yeah.
Yeah. You know, Jeff, he always ends up meeting, you know, backstage. He gets all the backstage stuff, you know. Oh, I was with Roger, you know, the other day, you know.
Yeah.
He has that knack of getting into gigs like that. He's well known, you know.
Yeah.
A lot of the people in the music scene around Dublin would have known Jeff, you know, go back. He moved here, you know, a long, long time ago. I saw footage of him, actually, RTE footage in 1973 in the Dandelion Market.
Yeah, I remember him in the Dandelion.
And it was an interview, RTE were interviewing him, you know what I mean? He goes back that far, you know. Yeah. As he'd say himself, oh, way back, you know.
Joe, 18 tracks on an album. It's kind of mind-blowing to see that you would have the energy to put it all together.
Yeah.
But then again, as you said, the songs come nice and easy to you. And it's a great gift that you have, that a song would arrive so easy. I remember, I'm not a songwriter, but I have a cracking old song. I remember, particularly the Stardust, I remember the Keegan's Way Back. And I know the year, and I still remember them saying to me, "Jeez, Kieran, could you have a cracker of a song?" And it didn't happen for 20 years. And I just wrote a song called John the Warrior.
Yeah, great.
I recorded it, and it got great interest all over the country. And one woman got in touch with me. The album that we done, myself and Des Tobin done, all the other tracks didn't matter on it.
This was the one.
And a woman tracked us down, and we launched it in every paper, Kim, because of the track. We were in the Belfast, the Cork papers, and this woman got in touch with me about a month later. She said, I've been tracking you down, I want to get 17 copies of the album off you. And she says, what way will I fix you up for them? And I said, I'll tell you what, I'll send them up to you. Whether you send the money down, that's up to yourself. And I'll trust you. And she did. You know, she wanted them for people around there. So it's great the power of a song can have. And I know that one about Iraq really is incredible. And the one about religion and your view and the way you would pull people back from where we're all drifting off.
Yeah.
And as I said, I'm one of those drifters. I find it hard to accept all the stuff that's going on around. I find it hard to accept there's a God out there.
I'm
being honest. You know, and for those songs that you're writing and putting them together, you know, if you get people, the whole thing is, that's why I was saying about this political thing, if it stops someone to think for a minute and they say to themselves, well, you know, I'm doing wrong or I'm going wrong or whatever, that's what songs do as well, you know.
Yeah.
And you've certainly got the power in those songs to do that. I have to say, as I said earlier on, Joe, I'm finding that some of the best work is coming out of you now.
Thank God, yeah, I'm up for air all right,
definitely, air, you know.
Thank be to God. I was down below in the...
You were, but sure, you, sure, you know what I mean. You've all reasons to, Joe. You know, as I said, we talked off air, and life is a life is a hard thing on us all. You know, we all have times, and we can pull through.
Yeah.
And as you all know, as we talked about suicide a minute ago, there's so much of it now. You know, now we want people to talk, and if people talk,
thank God, you know.
And if your song stops somebody for a second to think, you know. That's a powerful song.
Yeah, you know that
song has power in it. But, you know, you told me a story there. One lad played off this album, and he didn't do himself in, as we call it. You know,
people say,
people shouldn't be afraid to talk about it.
Absolutely, yeah.
And that's the most important thing. And we've all experienced it in our families. We all have that connection to someone that has left us that way, you know.
Yeah, my own brother, Declan, you know.
I know, yes, I knew Declan well.
Yeah, I remember that moment.
I remember, and I have to tell you, Joe, I don't know what you know this, and I'm sure while we're talking about Declan, we may as well talk about him a little
Absolutely.
Bit.
Absolutely.
Declan was a quiet kind of lad. He come up every Wednesday, and he sat there listening to the music quite as he did. I remember arriving up the following Wednesday, and I knew nothing about what happened. And I got an eerie feeling when I walked into the blue light. There was no one around, so I knew something was after happening. And I got the news when I was in there, and as I say, a couple of days later we were all in the church and stuff, and I'm sure you remember him on and off all the time, you know.
Oh yeah, constantly. Yeah. I've actually found, I was just telling Gavin the way, I found a tape that I'd recorded in 1992 in Westport. I was down seeing a guy called Connie Cullen, another great musician with Deck, and he was in great form, and things were going good, you know, But you know, he just couldn't take it, you know.
Absolutely.
But you know, we had an early trip. I lost my father when I was very young, and that had a knock-on effect. You know, it just took the family out. Basically, it was like a missile in the house. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So you know, I can see how he just couldn't keep going. You know.
And do you find it good to talk about all these things?
Yeah, I do.
Some people find it hard, you know.
No, I'll talk to anybody. I'll talk to anybody about it. You know, I don't want to force it on people's necks or anything. But it should be spoken about. Look, it's horrific. I mean, to be honest with you, you're gone for 7 years after something like that happens. It's very, very hard to crawl back out of it, you know. And
well, Joe, you certainly crawled out of everything in your life, whatever the journey. I don't know all your journey, but you've been up and down like a lot of us, and you certainly, as I said, you're the best is coming out, you know.
Yeah.
And I found when you look at, you know, I think the best came out Johnny Cash at his litter end, you know.
Ronnie
Drew, some of the best stuff come out of Ronnie at his litter end, you know. So whatever happens, whatever that reason is, you know.
Used to know, maybe you have to go, these are the things, the little trials of life, you know.
So, well, hopefully.
Actually, now that we talk about that, there's actually a song here, well, there's two songs. I was just wondering, would you be playing off the album? Now we're on the subject.
It's a song called
Pilgrim.
It's track number five.
And just on this particular track, so this is a song I wrote, again, you know, as a song of hope to people out there who might be going through hard stuff in life, you know.
Great.
And actually, my daughter, Pearl, is singing on this.
Oh, deadly.
So she's 12 years of age.
Hello, Pearl.
Oh, yeah, she said, don't mention me on the radio, Dad.
But
she's in bed. She should be in bed by now. Anyway.
All our listeners out there, Pearl is Joe's daughter, and she's singing on this track. So if she's sitting up the bed now, saying, "Oh no, Dad, you shouldn't have mentioned me." Well, because we know who you are now, and we're going to hear you singing on this track. Here's a song called Pearl. Is it?
It's called Pilgrim. It's called Pilgrim
with Pearl on it. Okay, on 103.2 Dublin City FM.
A word I say, just carry me along the way. Oh, we're all only pilgrims on the way. Ask me no questions now, and I'll tell you no lies. I'm traveling this road just like you on the way. On the way, oh pilgrim. Your brother took his life, they say. Don't know where he is today, eh? Oh, but I know that he guides you on the way, eh? His cross had crushed him to the ground. You try to carry it with him, oh, but like a bird with a broken wing, he could not fly. Every step, every step of the way, yeah. Turn your face to the sun, then we will embrace. And I know, yes, I know, we're gonna find the promised land. Oh, pilgrim.
Absolutely fantastic. Well done to Gavin Walsh for that recording.
Absolutely.
That's fantastic.
Top of the shelf, isn't he?
Absolutely fantastic.
Gavin, fair play to you, man.
That's some work. That's some work on that album.
Thank you.
You put some work in there, Gavin.
I just pressed a few buttons.
No, it doesn't matter. You pressed them right anyway.
You pressed them right.
I'll tell you that. Gavin, why did you do that? I was listening to kind of your mixed traditional music. Kind of with a kind of a funky, kind of rocky, and kind of electronic-y stuff all mixed
dance,
in there.
Just a dance beat, yeah, just a dance loop, really, you know.
Yeah,
put
yeah.
into it, along with acoustically recorded stuff. Just it sounds great, you know, to, both of them together, you know.
I know where to go on the next recording. Certainly, yeah.
Forward so orderly cue.
Anyone out there, Gavin Walsh, he's up on the Facebook page, and you will find him there if you can't find him on his own. But what's your picture profile or anything?
Ah, just Gavin Walsh. That's yeah. Just
you'll find him there, because if you're going to be his friends, you'll find Joe Dunn on it there as well, and you certainly will find me on it by tomorrow night, I'm sure. When I find him, we will make friends as well on it.
Actually, can I give out my website here? Sorry.
Oh, Joe. Yeah.
Sorry. Yeah. No. Just yeah. It's josephdunn.ie. josephdunne.ie.
Great.
It's just a little bit of stuff about me, you know. Yeah. Look, this website needs a bit of a kick in the arse, but sure, there you go. It is what it is for the
it
moment.
It is what it is.
Until we move up to the next stage for the new album off the Richter.
So you probably put it with, you know, with all the new technology, iTunes and all that kind of stuff. I prefer to have it like that now myself. I know, the old stock.
It is. The Hail Caesar is actually available on CD Baby. There's another gentleman who's been really good to me and who actually did my website and pays for it on an annual basis. His name is Morgan O'Connell. So he's another man who I forgot earlier to say say thank you to every single person who's helped me out, Joe, on this and prior to this. You know, it was 10 lepers, only one came back, you know what I'm saying?
Well, you know, to remember the name of Aileen Traxon, to remember all the musicians that's played over those few years with you, it's definitely a difficult situation.
Yeah, Mossy on Morrissey.
And then, you're in focusing on the songs in your head as well, and I understand that. That you wouldn't be remembered. Never. Who does, you know?
Yeah.
We're human. We're not computers. We do our best and we remember who we can on the night. And then sometimes, but you've got it, everyone, really, anyway. So you have. It's now almost 11 minutes to 11 o'clock, and George will be in here doing the Velt straight away after Sinead O'Fog and Ballot Show. Our special guest in here tonight is Mr. Joe Dunn, great friend of mine over all the years, and it's great to have him back in. And he has a great man here, as you hear, playing guitar with him, and he's recorded the album with him. And that last track is just superb at recording. For a man who would just use a computer and tools off a computer, you've certainly done a great job on it, Kevin.
Cheers, Karen. Thank you.
Fantastic altogether. Do you want to sing another song, Joe?
Yeah, sure. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, this is a kind of a newish one. It's called The Road to Jericho.
Is that going to be the name of the album?
Well, no. The name of the album is Off the Richter.
Off the Richter.
But then again,
could change.
That's a good name too, as well, doesn't it? Off the Richter seems to be the one that we went with for quite a while.
Yeah.
This is a song called The Road to Jericho, but it's about you know, even just like Jonah in the whale, you know.
Yeah.
You know the story about Jonah. He was trapped in the whale. So it's a song for anyone out there who might be feeling like they're at the bottom of the ocean, and but in the end, Jonah got out of the whale.
Did Joe, take it away.
Absolutely, thank you. I was on the road, looking for a sign to Jericho. No easy freeway here, you see, there's no easy ride. No shortcuts here, no place to hide on the road to Jericho. Was on the road to free my soul, on the road to Jericho. Oh, I was on the road to free my soul. I stuck my tongue out to hitch a ride, but I got run over by a Hell's Angels tribe. They struck me down, oh Lord, Lord, down to the ground. They left me bruised and battered, left me there to die. Then before me, as if in a dream, Jonah from the whale appeared to me. You know, he gazed in my eyes, oh, he never spoke a word. He just took my hand and beckoned, follow him on the road to Jericho. Oh, on the road to free my soul, on the road to Jericho. Oh, I was on
her own to free my soul. Came to the ocean's edge, I never asked, and you know I never will. To the ocean floor, deep down we sped, till the seaweed wrapped around my legs. Endless sleepless nights all, they flashed on by like in a movie as my life went by. But never once, no, never, never, never once in this darkened place did his gaze ever lose my face. On the road to Jericho, oh, I was on the road my soul, all on the road to Jericho. Oh, I was on the road to free my soul. Then at last I could touch the sky. And there before me now, 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 as the hills rolled by, you see, suddenly I could see Jericho. And then at last Jonah spoke a word. Never fear, never worry, 'cause I will always be, I'll always be there with you. Never fear, no, 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 no. You see, I will always be there with you on the road to Jericho. Oh, I was on the road to free my soul. Oh, 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 the road to Jericho. Oh, I was on the road free my soul.
Well done, Joe Dunn. Gavin Walsh. Our time has run out on us almost, and I want to thank you very much for coming in, Joe. It's great to have you. Come over to that mic if you want to say goodbye to anyone or hello to anyone. Gavin, come over there and say. And I'm going to finish off on track number two off the album here.
Well, so we can thanks a million, Kieran. Thank you so much for having us in. It's been an absolutely fantastic night. The 2 hours seemed like 2 minutes. Thank absolutely you for everybody fine for listening. Thanks to Gavin. Thanks to everybody. Thank you, Gavin. Thanks be to God.
Okay, and good night to everybody. And Mick O'Brien will be in the hot seat next week. Track number two, Joe, what's the name of there before I just put it
it's
on?
It's called Kings.
Okay, and we have George straight in on this. And thank you very much. Good night and God bless.
Which king? Many kings. Who's your king?
take me where the kings are awaiting. Don't take me where they're bowing to the ground. Come to the place where all things are equal. The judge and the jury nowhere to be found. 'Cause I can ride without them. I can ride without them. Don't take me there at all, no, no, no. Don't take me where the spin doctors ruin. Don't take me where they're making up our minds. Come to the place where freedom is calling. Sing freedom from those who meddle with your mind. 'Cause I can ride without them. Without them, don't take me there at all, no, no, no.